I'm Victor van der Valk. I'm 26 years old and I study at the Dutch Film Academy in Amsterdam. And we send it my film to the San Sebastian Film Festival, which is called Onno the Oblivious.
Ik kan u alleen vertellen dat Onno 26 jaar voorbij vliegen in een bad van warmte. Het land van ijs plaats heeft gemaakt voor het lage land, waar hij nu het gevoel heeft dat het allemaal net even anders in elkaar steekt dan zoals het eruit zag op het eerste gezicht. En u weet wat ik heb gezegd over dat eerste gezicht. Ik zal het u vertellen. Het verhaal over Onno de Onwetende, die het slachtoffer is geworden van het vriendengevoel.
Actually, Onno the Oblivious is kind of a personal story. And it's about a character who is actually going through his past, things that he witnessed when he was younger. Like for instance, the news that he heard his father had cancer, or love in Zambia, which didn't turn out to be good. And I thought, okay, it's not going to be a film which we are going to follow the psychology of the character. So it's going to be more like Bresson said, to use a model. And I thought, okay, I have to find someone who knows what I have went through without explaining too much, because it's kind of a weird story and it's actually about the unexplainable. And then I thought, well, there's only one guy who can do this, I think, which is my brother, who happens to be an actor. So actually, when I started writing, I knew he was going to play it. And we also wrote some of the voiceover texts together, and so that's actually how it started. Pierrot Le Fou from Godard, it was like, wow, what's happening here in this film? Because I didn't understand everything, but to me, I like a film which I don't understand actually. And I noticed that he wasn't following the main character as like, ah, I understand why Jean-Paul Belmondo is doing this, but he had, the main focus of the film was about love. His thoughts and ideas, his doubts about love. And then I thought, okay, that could also be a main start for a film. That I myself as a filmmaker can be really present in the film. That we don't have to hold back from, hey, you are watching a film. We can literally tell the audience, you are watching a film. It's constructed. And that's what I like about Godard, that he has the nerves to do like that. And then I think, okay, yeah, yeah, it brought so much inspiration. I had to put it in the film. Okay, the film is actually about thoughts. For me it works like thoughts, and a thought can be from one place to another place. You might be in that chapter and all of a sudden you go to the other chapter, bam bam bam. So I thought, and it goes really fast sometimes in my head at least. And then I thought, okay, I should not only focus on fiction film, because I could also make use of documentary things in it. To show you that documentary is also fiction, and that fiction could also be documentary. And I like to play with that. Like, what is, for me, there's no dividing line. It's all a film. You're just watching a film. And I thought, okay, I have to combine all these kind of footage to make the people realize that. And besides, to me, for myself, it's a big oath to filmmaking. It's actually, for me, it was like a search to why am I making film? And it's because it can comfort me. And in that case, I wanted to not only focus on like really fictionalized films, but like every time someone is filming, putting his camera on, for me, it means something. You can see something in the image or the way it's edited, then it can tell you something. And I wanted to emphasize that and to just bring an oath to us filmmakers, because in Holland it's often criticized, like, yeah, who needs film these days, or who needs arts these days? The government has cut back a lot on arts, and I thought, okay, well, this is the time to tell people, no, it's not really functional in the way you can earn money from it, but it's functional because you can get emotional about it, or it can give you comfort, or you can understand something better in which we can't discuss about in words or something. So I thought, okay, let's bring a big oath to cinema. Yeah, you could say that love is a really big part of the film, yeah, definitely. I mean, that's one of his most disappointing moments, that he thinks he finds a soulmate which he could share sadness with, but that soulmate is leaving him, is doing it for something else. So maybe that was the main key for him to get totally depressed, you know? So I think, yeah, you could say it's a it's really about love, but I think it's also about death. And like kind of the big questions in life, which I think we could talk about it. That was something we were quite struggling with in the edit. Like we had a script from like 50 pages, but the school allows us to make a film which is 25 minutes. So we had to cut back already a lot in the script writing. And then when we shot the film, we knew for some points how fast it should go. But in the edit, we should, you know, blend everything together, and we should take care that it still people could still follow it, you know, because maybe we have all the background information, but we should make sure the audience also can stick up to it. But I like it that it's a bit that the audience really has to walk behind it, you know. Oh, I'm not really getting it. Whoa, I can't, you know, I can't lose my mind. I have to focus. But he's not really quite there on the moment. I think the strong point of the film is that you can really think about it after the film because of the fast tempo. So you're like, what the fuck? What have I seen? What was it? Oh, it wasn't that and that. And you could maybe you wanted to see another time, you know. So it was something we really worked on hard, and like, how far can we go? Is this too fast or should it be a little slower? And of course, I think there's, besides the really fast points, there are also some slow parts where you can take a little rest, you know? And I think it's always a difficult balance, but I really like thinking about the tempo of film. And this film asked for a fast tempo, like I said, because of the thought that can jump from one place to another just in a second. Yeah, the school was like, it was a really hard year. Like, we worked on for 1 year on this film. So we started writing last summer, somewhere in June. And it was really difficult writing it. And, you know, you lock yourself down. And I had to go through all these bad memories, kind of, which I found out I didn't have to take care of them that good. So I went a bit in a depression. But then you start filming, so you come out of it again and you start editing it. And the school offers us really good help in funding the film. Besides that, we could fund the film just separately also. And they have a lot of good coaches who tell you, you know, you should do this or that, have you thought about this or that. And I mean, those 4 years at the school were really good for me. I think I really formed myself into a filmmaker that I want to be, and still I have to learn a lot, you know, and exploring myself, but I'm a little bit closer, and school helped a lot in that sense, I think. Yeah, I don't know, it's quite difficult in Holland in the sense, like, you have to choose what you want to do. There's a whole route for new filmmakers, but it starts with a 10-minute short film, and then you can climb up to a 40-minute, and then maybe a first feature. But to be totally honest, this project is not always making good films, like, because a lot of people are telling, you know, you have a lot of people who are telling you you should do this and that and that. So the freedom of a director is little, you know. And I know that I need a bit of freedom, because I can't, if you tell me where is Honor the Oblivious, what is it about, I can't pitch it in you like really sharp, you know. It's a film, you should see the film, then you know what it's about. And in Holland, that's kind of a difficult position. But we are fighting a bit against it. And I think we will manage our own way and create our own path. So I hope I'll be doing a feature film now in the future. Yeah, I'm thinking of 3 ideas, so I'm writing on it. So I hope I'll make one really soon.